A very good morning to you. It is Wednesday, the 2nd of September 2020, and this is your friend Angus Buchan with a thought for the day. If we go to the Gospel of Matthew chapter 5 and verse 9, the Word of God says, "Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called the sons of God." You know, to be a peaceable person is the opposite of selfish ambition. A peaceful person will always prefer others. A person who has got his own ends at stake and is not really concerned about anybody else is normally a troublemaker. Peace brings righteous conduct, which God always blesses. A peacemaker has the authority of God. A peacemaker, by the way, is not a sissy. The Bible doesn't say blessed are the peace lovers. No, no. Blessed are the peacemakers. And to be a peacemaker, sometimes you've got to stand up against what everybody else says, because what is right is right. By the way, you cannot generate peace. You either have it or you do not have it. Why? Because it comes from God. Blessed is the man who makes peace, for he shall be recognized as a true child of God. I don't know if you agree with me, but spending time with erratic people makes you very tired. It's hard work. The word erratic, according to the dictionary, is to stray, to be this way and that way. I want to say to moms and dads, you need to discipline your children if you want to have a peaceable home. And that's not a joke. Don't keep threatening your child, "I will do this if you don't do that," and you don't do it. You see, that's being erratic. Your child needs to know when he steps out of line, there are consequences for his action. He will be punished if he continues to tease or to hurt his little brother or sister. You can't keep saying, "I will smack you if you don't do that," and then you don't follow through. You have to be steadfast if you want peace in your home. You know, we have a saying here at Shalom, "The world stands aside for a man who knows where he is going." A peacemaker is self-assured. Why? Because he knows the Prince of Peace. Our yes must be yes and our no must be no. We can't blow hot and cold. We've got to be even-tempered. I remember a wonderful story many, many years ago. As a young man, 19 years old, I was at agricultural college in Bonnie, Scotland. And in the afternoons, we had to do practical work. I was sent out with an old Scotsman with a tractor and a trailer, and we had to go and collect silage. And that silage was very hard to get out of the pit. We didn't have a front-end loader like they have nowadays. We used forks. And he backed this huge trailer up against the silage pit, and he took off his jacket and he started putting the silage into the trailer. I said to him, "Sir, please sit down. I will do it myself." He said, "Don't worry, laddie. I'll do my bit and you do your bit." And we started. Well, I was extremely erratic. I went for it like a bull in a china shop. And after 20 minutes, I was exhausted. I was sweating, even though there was 3 foot of snow outside. And the old man just kept on steadily forking in the silage to the trailer. I want to tell you something now. That brought peace to my heart. I saw an old gentleman working like he'd been working for years. He knew where he was going and he knew what he was doing. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called the sons of God. God bless you and have a wonderful day.